I am Dr. Sriram Ramalingam, ophthalmologist and medical director, Pradnya Netralaya, Artinagar, Bangalore. Children are born with squint. But the squint is not visible immediately because a child born do not see clearly. The macula or the central vision starts developing only by the age of 3 months. Till the age of 3 months, the eye will have bizarre movement. They will not be able to focus. So squint will not be visible at this age. Squint becomes more prominent or visible after the age of 4 to 6 months of age. Squints, or strabismus as it is called technically, are of various types. Maybe an inward deviation called as an esotropia, outward deviation which is called as an exotropia, or an upper deviation which is called as an hypertropia. Depending upon the age of onset of the squint requires immediate treatment. If a child has got a squint which is visible from the age of 3 to 4 months of age, as soon as the squint is diagnosed, one need to operate on the child. Maybe by the child is 1 year of age, that is, we call these as infantile esotropias. They require immediate corrections so that the child can recover binocular vision. Correction, I mean, in the form of surgery. Occasionally, the inward deviation may appear after the age of 2 to 2.5 years of age. This is called as an accommodative esotropia. That is, these child, when they are examined, especially using eye drops, you will find that they have got a very high plus power, or what is called as an hypermetropia. Correcting the hypermetropia may decrease, or even the squint may disappear. But occasionally, even after correcting the hypertropia, a small amount of strabismus may remain. These are called as partially accommodative esotropia, and a surgery is required to correct the remaining component of the squint. If the child has got an exotropia, and if it is a constant exotropia, that is, it is present in all times of the day, then this child also requires immediate surgery. There is another type of an exotropia which is called as an intermittent divergent squint, where a squint or exotropia or the eye deviation outward is present only at certain times, that is, when the child is daydreaming or not concentrating. This type of squint can be observed, and if one finds there is a progression in the angle, or the squint degree of squint is increasing, or the squint is progressing faster, or is present in more than 50% of the waking hours, then these children require immediate squint. So a child requires squint as soon as it is diagnosed, not only to treat cosmetically and to regain 3D vision, but also to prevent children from developing what is called as lazy eye or amblyopia. A child with a deviating eye will always have subnormal or very poor vision in the squinting eye. So these children require squint as soon as it is diagnosed.